I was someone initially who would be very reluctant to take feedback and would go with my ideas and be like, hey, someone didn't like my ideas, I'm not a good designer. But soon I realized, like, you know, taking the designs and being separate from what you know, the feedback is to who you are as a designer is very important, because you're kind of like trying to take hypothesis, understanding of how people think and all of that, and mash up into a product flow. And that's not who you are as a designer. You're someone who is trying to like explain and sell that piece to your cross-functionals.
You studied IT and computer science in college. What got you interested in UX design?
My journey like into UX design was like very long-winded. When I started, I didn't have any idea there would be a job opportunity or like, you know, a career path in UX. I had a lot of interest growing up in sketching, drawing, and I was doing a lot of motion design on like PowerPoint and stuff. From there on, I kind of wanted to mix them together to do some sort of a program, which was like, you know, I can do computer science, but at the same time have my passion for drawing and sketching mashed up together. So while I was doing my undergrad in computer science and IT, I took a lot of courses which were like around computer animations, graphics, a lot of visual programming, and that kind of was something I was sticking by. After I graduated, I really wanted to do something with visual, connected with my programming background. So my first job was like a UI engineer, which was very much connecting to both worlds. That was in a startup, and that startup was working on iOS and Mac-related products, which kind of gave me a really good view of what the whole process looks like.
So you've worked at both startups and big companies. How do UX design roles differ between the two?
A startup generally looks for someone who is like, you know, passionate and about the design opportunity, really good at hard skills, and really good at communication. A lot of times, you know, big companies look for senior roles because they have, you know, their own needs to like, you know, ramp up fast, follow the teammates in terms of like, you know, getting design work done, validated, but have more experience to bring to the table. Depending on which state the startup is, a lot of times I came from having a startup experience where I was the only designer, and that brings its own challenges because you have to be really good at learning a lot by yourself. Really know that your value add is to bring new ideas to the table and know a lot around the products that's going around, like currently. Startup world, I would say, has a good mix of hard skills, communication that you need, at the same time, really fast paced. So you are not like refining, iterating the product as much as you would do in a big company. Knowing that, like, you know, having worked at LinkedIn and Facebook, I feel like the overall structure of a bigger company is very similar. They would want you to be very, like, you know, your decision making needs to be spot on. So the way you would make decisions, especially for designing for someone like in a space of million of users, you really have to be decision focused and opinionated at the same time. So knowing how to make decision based on data from user research, at the same time, you kind of want to bring your own perspective and user's perspective in there. You get everything in terms of like resources, which you don't in a startup world where you have to wear multiple hats. I used to do research myself, do like, you know, my iconography, do like, you know, visual design interaction. Everything would be, you know, host into my skill set. As much as you like to do that, you want to also focus and be good at one area, which is what like big companies give you. They give you a lot of time and resources to focus. But it comes with a trade-off. Like in a bigger environment, you only work on a smaller piece of the puzzle, where in a startup, you kind of own the whole area.
What traits or skills do startups look for when hiring their first few designers?
In terms of startups, you know, the general rule of thumb has been someone who can do multiple or like wear multiple hats, especially being good at hard skills such as like visual design, being able to do iconography themselves, or actually have like an understanding of what kind of visual language they want to go for. At the same time, interaction design and making prototypes and able to like, you know, share those concept mocks and prototypes in real time, like with the people, the stakeholders. My startup experience, especially at my goal, I was someone who was managed by a product manager, like a CEO, very, very real face-to-face interaction, the same in some of the other startups I work with. So the bigger piece out of there was how I communicate with them, especially knowing these are folks who really want to really be involved in the product design process, but also I need to explain why I made a decision on going with a particular color palette, or why the next screen has to be a particular screen from the previous one. So it's a lot of decision making, but at the same time you have to educate, which made me understand like explaining or talking in the language like my product manager would talk, because they're the one, or like my director of product would talk. That's important to them, so they can take that forward. We used to have a lot of critiques at the same time, so being able to be a good presenter, so at the same time, be able to take feedback was important.
On a different note, what skills or traits do companies like LinkedIn or Facebook look for when hiring designers?
The overall interview process was always around, you kind of go and present your portfolio. So portfolio is a must. And I think I take pride in my portfolio, and I kind of like also help critique other people's portfolio. It's one of the pieces which gives a great impact to the people looking at your work, because that's kind of like who you are, and it can show more than what you can actually say in person. So, it gives you also a good chance to showcase your visual design, because a lot of time projects in the past might not be representative of who you are or what you can do in terms of skills from visual design perspective. From there on, the other things that big companies look for is how good are you as a team player. So a transition from startup to a big company like or tech company, or even like a big agency, would be collaboration and communication. So having a skill which I had to develop in terms of knowing what kind of information which audience needs, or like what kind of terminology or kind of different acronyms people would use in a UX design world would be different from a product design. When they ask, why was a particular decision made by you or anybody else in your team in the past, is it based on just like gut instinct, or is it grounded in terms of research, user feedback, or even like data? User feedback could be a great way to have a way to qualify some of these quantitative insights from like data science. You could have a mix of both to help inform your design decision. Because a lot of times you might think everybody knows about it. You might be the only one who's trying to like talk it through and like explain to other folks. So it's important to use data, how you measure success in your designs, how you go about showing that there is value in what you're trying to propose. Are kind of important. Facebook, for example, or LinkedIn is the same, has a design system. So a design system helps to like reduce like redundancy of code, but also like redundancy of like making the same kind of designs again and again. But it also brings consistency. So you need to be able to use some of these design systems, but also know when you need to like go and create a new design pattern. Attributes would be having a great piece of portfolio to speak for your work in the past. If you don't have one, work towards building a good portfolio, get it critiqued, get it like practice how you present that. It's kind of like the core of how you go approach any big company. Being a very good collaborator and communicator, show skills where you are able to express yourself, show areas where you have taken research into picture, taking design decision based on data. And the last piece would be how you go about having taken the first two, but be able to like adapt like a design system, a more scalable solution to your design skills.
What's the hardest part about being a UX designer?
The hardest part about being a UX designer for me is to create a long-term vision for the design work you're doing or the problem you're trying to solve. Having your teammates be able to come along with the journey and the vision you want to showcase. At the end, you really want to have understanding of the problem area from end to end, because some of the areas that I work in are so ambiguous, you really can't search for them. As a designer, the critical piece for showing a vision is how you bring your cross-functionals along with the journey. So I use different kind of techniques, or I would say different methods. One of them is to host a brainstorm sessions with everybody in the room. We kind of have at Facebook or at LinkedIn, we kind of have your product manager, your engineers who are back-end engineers or front-end. You'll have a data scientist, your researcher. We also have a content strategist. So people who are really involved in a day-to-day product come into a room. They have the background knowledge of what the problem we're trying to solve. And then we kind of come together, do a couple of brainstorming activities, have a specific problem area in mind. And that's how we kind of start our road mapping. And that road mapping kind of helps understand, hey, is it a 2-year roadmap or is it something for the next half? And we could come up with a 2-year roadmap and kind of like have a finite set of things that we want to do the next half, which is great. And that goes into like, you know, the whole process of how I as a designer can facilitate that session, can bring people together, take the ideas, show some designs or mocks which are inspirational, and use that as a launchpad for me to like, hey, we are working on the next, you know, vision of the product. The younger me would say like, hey, I would just do what my like, you know, product manager wants to do or my like, you know, design manager wants to do. I'll just work on this, you know, little sectioned out piece, and that's what I would be focusing on. But I think it's important to branch out of that. You are as much a product owner as anybody else in your team is. So, and you understand both the piece as a designer, you have to understand the data side of it, but also you have to understand like where the user's perspective is, and you're the one who is like speaking on their behalf.
How is Facebook design culture different than all the other companies you've worked at?
I think Facebook takes pride in having the designers just not be a UX designer, it's a product designer. So one of the important thing I realized as I went in, you are the owner of the product and they really want you to be someone equal to a product manager or engineer. Facebook is great at giving you all the tools that is required. The amount of internal tools we have is kind of makes the life easier as a designer. At the same time, it's a very transparent company internally. I'll give an example of some of the areas I worked in recently, which made me, you know, make my whole design process very fast. So I have a team of three, you know, in terms of a researcher, a content strategist who kind of works on the content related stuff, and I'll be the product designer who will pretty much own the area of which I'm designing. In this particular trifecta of design, we kind of know and talk about like where the things are that we need to focus on. Especially if we want to be in early stage of a design process, we'll go and kind of find the users we want to talk with. I work in an ads and business platform, so it's a very back-end heavy, or I would say technical heavy areas or expertise, which is different from where I'm coming from LinkedIn, which was like a LinkedIn profile. Everybody knew what the function and the form factor is. So it's important for me to really know the area in and out in detail and have a knowledge about it so I can add value to the team by asking the right questions and building the right kind of like tools for the people using that platform. But at the same time, I work with researcher and content strategists. They also have a similar set of questions that they kind of help me with. So they kind of bring their critical thinking to the table as much as the skill they have individually. At Facebook, I think I talked about how we are like how the whiteboarding piece is important. How can you kind of explain your ideas in a fast-paced way? We have a very big design community, which helps to like learn from each other. So prototyping is a big piece of it. And I think I can't stress how much that's important, even if you're in a consumer-centric design world or in a, like in a business product-centric design world. Prototyping kind of helps you know, expedite that process and has been one of the tools I always keep like my hands like, you know, really fresh on it, and any new design tool that comes in, you know, make sure I'm like ahead of the game so I can keep up with the rest of the folks.